Hello everyone, this is Tuhin Banik from ThatWare, and today we will be discussing about redirections. Now, what is redirection? So basically, redirection is sending visitors, both human being and Google bots, to a different URL from an existing URL. So this is the main difference of a redirection. Now, there are various types of redirection, like there is 301 redirection, there is 302, 303, 307, 308. Now we'll be like dissecting them into two categories. The first category is a permanent redirection, where only 301 and 308 happens, and the other version is temporary redirection, where only 302, 303 and 307 operates. Now in the fields of search engine optimization, redirections are also known as 3xx, because every response code starts with a 3. Now let us discuss what a permanent redirection is and what a temporary redirection is. Now, even though there is a lots of differences from a technical point of view, like how a get request or how a post request is modified or served between the user and the client end side, but to make it more precise to our discussion on the SEO, a temporary redirection does not process link juice, or in other words, this does not pass any SEO benefits when a redirection happens from one URL to the other URL. Whereas a permanent redirection passes near about 90% of the link juice, or 90%, in some cases 100% of the SEO benefits to the newly modified URL from its existing URL. So this is the basic difference between the temporary versus permanent redirection. Now let us explore each of them one by one. So let us start with 301. So 301 is the permanent redirection, where a client can serve between both the requests, both get and post, at the same time. And 308 is also a permanent redirection, but on the new URL, the client needs to choose only get, request, post, and he cannot switch between either of the requests. So for SEO experts, it's always advisable to use 301 redirection if you are changing your particular URL to your new URL structure. Like if you're having a broken link and you have modified a particular link structure, you want to switch the link to the new link structure, then you should be using a 301 redirection. Then this would pass all the existing benefit from the previous URL to the new URL structure. Now let us discuss about the temporary redirects, 302, 303 and 307. Even though 302, 3 and 7 serve the main purpose of temporary redirection as seen from the SEO spectrum, however, as seen from the screen, 303 and 307 can have different gestures and they can have different requests, as you can see from the text showing up on this video. Now we'll only discuss about 302 from the temporary redirection, because this is used in the SEO thing. So 302 means that you are not passing any SEO benefit, or you are not passing any SEO link juice, to be precise, to your newly modified URL structure. Now I'll tell you some of the difference or key differences why 301 and 302 are applicable in the fields of SEO. Now there is five instances. The point number one is, first of all, if you have a broken link and you have fixed that link, you want to switch the visitors from the previous to the new link, you need to use a 301, because you need to pass all the SEO benefits from the first to the last one. Second thing, if you are merging your pages, like you are combining all of your pages into a one, or if you are combining many of the duplicates pages into a one, then also you need to use a 301 redirection, because you need to make sure that your SEO juices gets passed into the main version. Then the third case is 307. For a difference, 307 can be used on bank pages transaction, because you need to make sure that it is temporarily redirected whenever you are doing a bank online transaction, and you need to make sure that there is no data passing between the redirections. So this is an exceptional case which happens during transactional activities. Point number four, PR302 redirection. This can happen, suppose if you are having a construction page on your website which is temporarily hidden, or maybe this is temporarily like out of bound index, or it's 404, it's not found, and there can be any reasons which make sure that your existing page do not have any SEO value, and you need to make sure that you are redirecting the visitors to a new URL. In that case, you need to use a 302 redirection, because if you use that, then it would make sure that nothing bad SEO benefits is shifted onto the new domain. And the last point, but not the least, is 303 redirection, which you also name as see other. As you can see from the differentiation on the screen, that it stands for see other. In other words, it is used for sending visitors to a temporarily available section of your website. Suppose you are building a landing page for driving in some traffic from some of your part of your A/B testing. In that case, you can use a 303 redirection, because in that case, like, Google would not take those into the index point of view, they would not take that into the crawlable point of view, and also there would be no chances of SEO getting damaged. Also, there is no chances of any information getting misplaced. So this is an exceptional point which is only applicable if you are using a paid marketing, or you are doing an A/B testing to build a landing page to redirect traffic into your landing page from any other variants of your thing. So this needs to be temporarily available, else this server would not be purpose. So once again, thank you for watching, and I hope you have enjoyed watching this video. Thank you.